Hi, I'm Tamara Holder, and welcome to Sports Court. During the Kansas City-New England game, Chiefs safety Husain Abdullah intercepted Tom Brady's pass and scored a touchdown. But then he was flagged for unsportsmanlike conduct going to the ground. Why? Because the ref misinterpreted his traditional Muslim prayer to be a celebration. So should prayer have a place on the football field? Joining me from Denver is David Treadwell, former NFL kicker for the Broncos and current radio sports radio personality. Hi, David. How are you?
Hi, Tamara. Thanks for having me on the show.
Well, let's talk about Denver. You're a Denver guy. You played for the Broncos. Tim Tebow was notorious for his prayers and his prayer dance. Regardless of religion, do you think that this is a distraction or acceptable on the field?
I think it's acceptable on the field. Tim Tebow had a great run here in Denver with the Broncos, and it became very acceptable. But there's been prayer around the NFL for a long time. It wouldn't be so public and pronounced as it was with Tim. He made it popular. But most often after games...
But you're not
games,
answering the question. Is it a distraction?
Teams would get together and pray after the fact. They would. And in this case, Husain Abdullah, when he intercepts the pass, I don't think that referee knew he was praying. He just thought he was celebrating. How did he not know he was going on the ground exhaustion?
Well, I'm sure he's not that exhausted. But anyway, let's talk about this unsportsmanlike conduct rule that's directly from the NFL. It says that individual players involved or prohibited from engaging in any celebrations while on the ground. That's the piece of the rule that I'm quoting. So here's this ref who's throwing this flag. Now, I want to go to a tweet. NFL expert Mike Piera actually tweeted last year about this rule, and he said, quote, "You're not penalized for going to the ground to give praise after a touchdown." So is this some miscommunication the ref didn't know?
It possibly could be. There's some subject to interpretation left there. But I think the NFL, even back in my day in the 80s and the 90s, we thought NFL stood for no fun league. You got to have some fun. There's got to be some excitement around the game when you score a touchdown.
Okay, but we're not talking about fun. We're talking about a rule that I would think is in place because maybe the NFL wants to protect their players. And so the guy gets on the ground, whether it's with one knee or both knees, head on the ground. Isn't this a safety issue? You have these big guys jumping on top of each other.
Somewhere along the line, somebody probably took it too far. Some receiver probably did the worm in the back of the end zone. What they're trying to do is prevent it being all about me. I don't think they mind celebration if they're team celebrations. What they don't want are the individual
celebrations. But that's what this is, Dave. This is you started by saying that it's okay that Tebow and all these other players do this, but that they can't do it. They can't do these prayers. I mean, which one they can't celebrate? Which is it?
Well, it sounds like they're allowed to pray and offer a quick prayer, but what they don't want is them going to the ground and doing something other than prayer. That's okay. The difference in the interpretation.
So now we have CARE, the Muslim rights group that's coming out. The NFL recently released a statement that there was a mistake, that he shouldn't have been flagged. So what do we do now? Do players, and I'm not trying to be funny about this, do players disclose their prayer practices to the NFL? Do they train refs that one kind of guy may pray one way, another kind of guy with another religion may play another way?
It probably will come up in some discussions that they'll have to be more open-minded to that and not so quickly reach for the flag to try to understand exactly what the player is doing in that specific circumstance.
So don't you think this is now just muddying the waters? Let's just have prayer before and after games and play 60 minutes of football.
True, but you see players always, a lot of times, they'll point to the sky like they're pointing to God because they made a great play. Is that something that they're going to outlaw as well?
Well, I don't know. If there's a flag thrown, I guess then we have the problem all over again. So we'll
right.
see.
There's already too much legislation in the NFL. There's already too many flags in the game as it is. It's becoming an unwatchable game. It was a great game because of the way it flowed and the rhythm of the game. But if you're throwing a flag every other play, it becomes unwatchable.
All right. Well, we'll see if any more flags get thrown for people praising Jesus or Allah or whatever. I don't know. It's weird. Anyway, thank you for joining me, And I want you all to follow David on Twitter. He's very active, at Kicking Bronco. And I'm on Twitter, at Tamara Holder. Thank you for joining us. Sports Court is adjourned.